Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial dedicated to C#. In just 15 minutes, we will see everything you need to know to realize your first script. C# is an object-oriented coding language similar to JavaScript, Java, C++, and Visual Basic, often used to develop desktop, mobile, and web applications, up to games and complex software. To start coding with C#, you need an integrated development environment, IDE. For example, Visual Studio, able to compile and debug your code. You can install its free community version, including the .NET desktop development needed to run the C# code. As you open Visual Studio, go to Create a New Project and select Console Application. Set the project name, where to save it, and the name for the solution, intended as the entire C# code you are going to build. As .NET framework, you can leave 3.1 or go for the latest one. This is needed to run scripts and libraries used while coding with C#. When you start with a new C# code, this usually includes default instructions or statements, such as pasting on the console the classic Hello World. You can also see its basic structure. You get the namespaces that collect several classes, where each class groups several statements and operations to perform under braces. In this case, you have a single example namespace and a single program class. By default, you also get the main function, which defines the heart of your C# code. To paste the Hello World text, you simply call the default console class, add a period, and then write line, with its content under parentheses. This is a standard C# operation made available by the default system namespace declared on top through using system. The script may include spaces and new lines that improve its readability without impacting its result. It also needs a semicolon every time you end any statement. The code is then saved under a .cs file within the folder path specified. To run the script, go to Debug, Start Debugging, or just press F5. Now let's see how to work with the variables. These are elements that save data under a defined name. Type int to define a variable that must save an integer numerical value, and then type its name, number, with an equal to assign the value to save, 8. Always end the statement with semicolon. You can verify the result with console write line with the variable name as input. In the same way, you can type string to define variables, saving text strings under double quotation marks, char to save text characters under single quotation marks, and double to get numerical numbers with decimals separated by their period. You also type bool to set Boolean variables that can be either true or false. You can also put together or concatenate multiple variables and pieces of text by using the plus operation. In this case, you drop text under double quotation marks and use a plus sign to continue with the number variable. To transform lines into comments, either use forward slash to comment a single line or forward slash asterisk and asterisk forward slash to comment entire blocks. All commented lines will turn in green color and get completely ignored by the compiler. Very useful to make tests without deleting and losing any statement. On numerical variables, you can type plus and asterisk to perform additions and multiplications, and dash and forward slash for subtractions and divisions. You can also include parentheses if necessary. Consider that non-integer divisions get rounded when saved inside an int variable. With C#, you can also say values inserted via console. If you define a vacant data1 variable and assign to it console.readline with parentheses, the console waits for the user input that gets saved inside data1 when the enter key is pressed. This is very useful to make logins and prompts as long as it is supported by instructions through console.writeline. On C#, you can also make conditionals with if used to run statements only in case a specified condition is true. Type if the condition under parentheses A greater than B, and then all the statements under braces. You can go on with else to run other statements in case the condition above is false. Whereas, use else if to specify another condition under parentheses. Besides the greater than, you can also use less than, equals to say equal, exclamation mark equal to say different than, and also logic operations such as vertical bar to perform an OR and double ampersand to perform an AND. Besides the if, you can use the switch cycle to take into account several possible values or cases over a single variable. Type switch, the variable under parentheses, in this case an integer one, and the braces. Then type case, the value to match, colon, and then all the statements to follow if this case is true. Each case must end with the break line and semicolon. You can also include a default case that is run when none of the cases above is matched. Whereas, if you need to run several statements at a defined number of times, you can implement the for cycles. Type for and specify three inputs under parentheses and separated by semicolon. The first part collects the assignments, including the I variable used to count the cycles. Then you specify the condition to respect, such as I less than 3, and then the increment on such I counter at the end of each cycle, written as I plus plus, or as an increment of itself by 1. The for statements, always within braces, get repeated until the I counter does not respect the condition any longer, so when I is equal to 3. Another useful cycle is the while. This is used in case you need to repeat statements as long as a condition is true in an undefined number of times. Type while, its condition under parentheses, and then all its statements within braces. The cycle will repeat until the condition becomes false, so make sure to evolve the variable within the condition or you will end up in an endless cycle causing errors. Similar to while is the do cycle, with the only difference that you specify the statements first and then the condition in the end next to while. This means that you run the statements at least once before verifying or exiting the cycle. With C#, you can also work with elements called arrays. These contain an ordered list of values of the same kind and under the same name. Define the data type with square brackets to make an array, then type array name, equal, and its content under braces and separated by commas. In this case, you build a string array, so you have to add quotation marks on each text value. At this point, you can access to any of the array elements by typing the array name and its index number under square brackets. Pay attention that this starts from zero, so you may use the for index to catch the cake fifth element. In the same way, you can assign other values, make operations or paste data through a for cycle using the iCounter as an index number. In this case, the .length extracts the total number of array elements. This is an example of function or method often used on C# to define complex and custom operations to perform anywhere in your code. By default, you have the main method that identifies the script run by the compiler. After its brace, you can create another method by typing static void and its name. The void defines a method that does not return any output. Next to the method name, you can specify any input under parentheses or leave them vacant if you do not need any. Then, drop all the statements to run under braces. You can call this method within the main script and run its statements by typing its name and adding its vacant mandatory parentheses. Whereas, if you add inputs, you have to define their data kind and separate them with commas. When you call this method, you also have to specify the values for these inputs in order, in this case, 10 for H and steps for name. If you want to return any value, just type static and define the output data kind, for example, double, followed by method name and inputs. Among the statements, you can add the return keyword to save the method output, for example, the product of the two inputs given. The same system namespace collects loads of ready-made methods you can use. For example, the array sort, applied to any array, gives its elements listed by following an alphabetical order. And the convert method converts the data kind of any variable to another. Please check our video description to learn more about the default methods inside C#. When the script starts to be long, it is very useful to group statements and methods under several namespaces, classes, and external files. You can create a new .cs file and save it within the project directory. Then make a new class on it with public class and its computer name within a new namespace called tech. Each class has its own variables. If you define a new string variable, this is visible only within its computer class. Whereas, if you type public string, you make the variable visible across all the other classes, including the ones under the example namespace. Here, you will have to include the new tech namespace by typing using tech above. Let's use this public structure variable within the objects. The objects are virtual representations of physical objects with own properties and data or fields derived from the same classes they belong to. To define a new object inside the computer class, type computer, the object name, equal, and the new keyword with computer again, and its parentheses. At this point, if you type the object name, period, and the variable structure from the computer class, we will save its data as a new MyRig field. This works as long as you include the tech namespace above with its computer class defined as public. You can make assignments and concatenations with objects as seen. Now that we have seen all the basics, you can understand this simple C# code. This solution asks name and age with a readline command, calculating the maximum heart frequency from these. And if, ask the user whether to show additional data with closing lines in the end. You can download this sample script in the video description. When your script is ready, you can build the final exe by going to Build Solution. With this, you can run the entire script without the support of any IDE such as Visual Studio. Thanks very much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to check our video description to get additional help and tips, and subscribe to our channel for other free, outstanding tutorials in the future.